In this episode of Drinking Made Easy, we head to the southernmost point in the continental U.S., the Conch Republic. We hang out with some of Hemingway's cats, throw back a dark and stormy.
Sounds like you guys might need an excuse to have a party.
And that was an awesome excuse.
And I enjoy a bucket of rum. It's Drinking Made Easy, Key West. I'm Zane Lamprey, and my job is to drink. I'm traveling around with my mascot, Steve McKenna, and my buddy Pleplius, as we explore the local drinking cultures, customs, and cocktails. Along the way, we'll soak in the local flavor in an effort to make drinking easy. For our first stop, we hop on a boat and make our way over to the Schooner Wharf Bar. It's located on land, but it actually started on a boat.
See, the original bar was actually on a schooner, on a boat.
It was actually on a schooner. It was on a schooner that my husband and I sailed into town on. Then we were told that it's a non-traditional use by the state to serve alcohol over on a boat, so we moved on shore.
Their signature drink is a favorite among sailors. It's called the Dark and Stormy. The Dark and Stormy is made with dark rum, ginger beer, fresh ground ginger, and garnished with a lime.
Dark and Stormy seems like something that a sailor wouldn't want to engage themselves in.
Evelina and her husband opened this bar, and they're avid sailors. Maybe she can shed some light on why it's called the Dark and Stormy.
I'm a sailor, and I think that is when things get exciting, when it's dark and stormy.
I'll take that.
I like it. All my sailor friends drink it, especially after we've been out racing. We come back to dark, and you gotta have a Dark and Stormy.
Got it. And this is Conch Republic dark rum. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is.
It's not made in the Conch Republic, but it's made in the spirit of the Conch Republic. What's the conch spirit?
On April 23rd, 1982, Key West attempted to secede from the United States, at which point they adopted the name Conch Republic. After seceding, they then tried to get foreign financial aid from the U.S. That is ballsy.
Well, they set up a roadblock, and it was to check for illegal aliens. And what it ended up doing was just basically cutting off the keys for like a day or two.
So then you guys said, "F that." Pretty much. And you guys tried to secede from the United States, right?
Yes, we had a little town meeting down there with our mayor, who was Dennis Wardlow at the time.
Okay.
A lot of local people gathered there, and that's what we said. We were going to, you know, become
secede.
Our own.
And then you asked for...
We were going to become the Conch Republic.
You asked for financial aid or military support?
From the government, because we were basically cut off. We depended on the tourists, and we had none of that going on.
So you guys seceded, and then you asked who you seceded from for aid.
Yeah.
I didn't get it, but you know, it got us a lot of attention.
Yeah, that's perfect. And now you guys are the Conch Republic.
And Schooner Wharf Bar is actually the official headquarters of the Conch Republic Independence Celebration, and we just had about 10 days worth of festivities here.
Really? Sounds like you guys might need an excuse to have a party.
Well, you know what?
A little bit.
Yes. Okay. And there are a lot of excuses around here in Key West, and that was an awesome excuse.
The Dark and Stormy starts with rum, and then it's topped off with ginger beer.
I'm not shaking. I'm just looking at the underneath of the seat, make sure that the...
Okay, because that will blow up when you open it. All right.
Is that a Dark and Stormy? It's just those things?
Yeah.
Then here at the Schooner Wharf Bar, they top it with fresh ground ginger.
A little bit of that goes a long way.
And the lime.
Cheers.
Here's to you, Zane.
Here's to you, Vicky.
Beautiful job.
Cheers. Here's to you guys.
Here's to my boss, Evelina.
Yes.
Here's to you.
Here's to having fun.
Here's to your boss.
That's right.
Here's to you.
This is so good.
Now I get the stormy part of the whole deal. I wasn't trying to like show off. I was just drinking it and trying to keep conversation. I was not paying attention to the fact that I drink the whole time.
We got
to
start over again at 7 o'clock in the morning.
Oh. Sounds like my life.
Since I didn't really get to enjoy the Dark and Stormy, I decided to make one of their signature cocktails, Schooner Breeze.
You guys enjoy those, and we're gonna make a Schooner Breeze.
Yes, we are.
The Schooner Breeze is made with pineapple rum, mango rum, coconut rum, banana rum, pineapple juice, cranberry juice, dark rum, and garnished with a lime wedge. I attempt to show off my skills by pouring all four bottles of rum at once. That didn't work out.
Start with like those two, and those.
Each Schooner Breeze gets a half ounce of four different kinds of rum, pineapple, mango,
it's almost in the glass,
coconut, and banana.
All right.
A dash of pineapple juice.
Pour a little bit of that in each one of those.
Is that
good.
A little bit?
That's good.
A splash of cranberry, then float dark rum on top.
Right. I'm pouring these in the spirit of the Czech Republic.
All right.
Finally, garnish with a lime wedge, and my personal touch, a sprig of mint.
Hey, how about that?
I can't think of a healthier diet than a schooner breeze in the morning. That one's yours.
All right.
That one's yours.
Cheers.
We're racing, you guys.
Hey, you guys are cheating.
I'll help you when I'm done.
You guys take about three times as long as we took.
We have two. You have one glass.
Oh, you really did do
two. You're already losing count.
What, I feel like I just got conked in the head?
Our next stop is a favorite watering hole of Ernest Hemingway. And every year, Sloppy Joe's holds a Hemingway look-alike contest. We sat down to have some drinks with one of their past winners and our Hemingway look-alike, Steve McKenna.
Who is Hemingway?
Oh, boy.
Did you take English in school at all? Or?
Hemingway was an American author who wrote, among other things, A Farewell to Arms and The Old Man and the Sea. He had a house in Key West that is now a museum and home for a bevy of six-toed cats. He was also known as a man who liked to drink and could probably put Steve McKenna to shame.
So the more he drank, the more he wrote, and the more he wrote, the more he drank.
He was more inspired. Why did they call it Sloppy Joe's?
Back in the day, it wasn't only a bar, it was an ice house. So the floors were always wet in the bar. So Ernest said, Joe, you've got a sloppy place here, Sloppy Joe's.
So this place was named by Ernest Hemingway.
Yes.
But it wasn't originally here, is that right?
Right. It was at Captain Tony's, which is just down the block here on Green Street.
Okay.
In 1936, the owner of the property went up on the rent from $4 to $5, $1.
It's $4 a month?
Yes. Didn't make Mr. Sloppy Joe Russell very happy. And he told everybody to grab a bottle of booze, grab your bar stool, or move it in a new place. And then it moved here in 1937, where it still is today. Forget the things you
left behind. So they moved all the furniture over.
Just the bar stool and the booze. And the band.
So, one drunken evening, Sloppy Joe moved his bar a few buildings away to where it is now on Duval Street. One of Ernest Hemingway's favorite cocktails was the Papa Doble. The original recipe from Cuba was a blended drink made with 2.5 ounces of rum, 2 fresh limes, the juice of 1/2 of a grapefruit, and 6 drops of maraschino cherry liqueur. But Sloppy Joe's version is made with white rum.
These are healthy pours.
That's what we do here. It says it right on our sign. Generous pour.
Sour mix, grapefruit juice, grenadine, rolled back and forth with a shaker tin, and topped off with soda water and a squeeze of lime.
This is like one of those shows where like you get to meet yourself in the future. Do you have any advice for your past self?
Yeah, keep drinking. And then it all works out.
I mean, come on. What did you expect future Steve to say?
It's really good.
I can't keep up with the Hemingways. Congratulations. Cheers.
Cheers.
Okay, now that Steve's up to speed on Hemingway, I jump into Sloppy Joe's signature cocktail, the Sloppy Rita. The Sloppy Rita is made with tequila, triple sec, sour mix, orange juice, and club soda.
You've done this before.
I've done it. Few times, not as many times as Hemingway.
In a cup of ice, pour 1 ounce of tequila and 1/4 ounce of triple sec.
4 to 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That one's mine.
It is?
How do they look?
Great.
That's what I'm looking for.
Next, a dash of orange juice. Then top with sour mix.
Sour.
Splash of club soda in each one. It's not a great margarita till you shake them up really nice. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Salt it around the rim. Squeeze a lime in there.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. Cheers to Papa Hemingway.
Here's to Papa.
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 Here's to Key West.
Coming up on Drinking Made Easy, Shuck Bucks.
A little something extra for you in there, too.
Thank you very much.
Welcome back to Drinking Made Easy. As you know, Drinking Made Easy isn't just a show about drinking, it's also a drinking game. So whenever you see a jet ski during this little thing we're doing right here, you have to drink. What are the other rules?
Drink. Rule number one is if you're the first person to see Pleplez, you get to make somebody else drink.
Whenever I burp, you have to go like this. The last person to do it has to drink.
Whenever Zane drinks, you get to drink.
For more rules, go to drinkingmadeeasy.com.
We're drinking our way through Key West. And our next stop is Pepe's Cafe, the oldest eatery in Key West. They first opened their doors in 1909. Every week they have an oyster shucking contest, and today it's me versus Steve.
Twice a week you do a oyster shucking contest.
Well, it's actually an oyster that we call it an oyster race because they're racing against the clock. And I time each one with a stopwatch, quick as shuck the oyster is the winner.
I bet the people who come in here and do this are professionals to some degree.
Yes, okay. Always.
We are the farthest from a professional oyster shucker.
I'm a professional drinker.
It's time for the six-pack challenge. So here's the deal. In every episode of Drinking Made Easy, Lamprey and McKenna compete in a six-pack challenge. The loser buys the winner a six-pack of beer. Before they start, you decide who's going to win, and if you lose, you drink. For today's challenge, Lamprey and McKenna are going to see who can shuck six oysters the fastest. The winner gets $10 in shuck bucks, redeemable at Pepe's Key West.
On your mark, Steve, and shuck!
Now keep in mind, this is dangerous. The knife is sharp, and our mascot is not. McKenna is puttering along on a second oyster. If not for that towel there, this would be one bloody shellfish. There's a gooey number six.
153. Yeah. Let's hear it for Zane.
And Lamprey wins today's six-pack challenge.
I just keep winning.
I take my shuck bucks and head to the bar.
You probably heard the news around town, right, about the shuck bucks?
Yeah.
I got some money to spend, and I'm going to spend it here. Because it's not going to do me anything anywhere else.
No.
We order up to a Florida beer company's Key West Sunset Ales.
To Jimmy.
Refreshing.
Thank you.
That beer hit the spot. But before we get comfortable, we head down the road to Island Dogs to meet up with a buddy of ours, Pat Croce. Pat's a former owner of the 76ers, a sports medicine pioneer, best-selling author, but more importantly, owner of several iconic Key West bars, including Island Dogs. We started off by throwing back their signature cocktail, the Key Lime Pie Martini. The Key Lime Pie Martini is made with vanilla vodka, coconut rum, lime cream liqueur, lime juice, fresh key lime wedges, and rimmed with a graham cracker crust. Start by chilling the glasses with ice and water. Then to the shaker, add a 4 count of vanilla vodka.
3, 4, 7, 8, 5, 6, 6, 10, 9, 9, 10.
People are like me.
I feel pretty good about that.
In this case, we're making 5 drinks and 2 shakers. So I bump up the recipe. Add a long pour of coconut rum.
I hope that's all that goes in there.
Absolutely not.
Okay.
That's okay.
Then add lime cream liqueur.
3 count of
that.
Oh
my God, look at that.
Oh, and save some room on top for the lime juice.
There you go.
Okay.
Rim the chilled martini glass with a lime wedge, then dip it into the graham cracker crumbs.
It's like s'mores for drunk people.
No, it's a key lime pie. That's the point that you're missing. This whole drink tastes like a key lime pie.
Fill to the rim, add a lime wedge, and enjoy.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Salud.
We then move on to the Island Dogs Mojito. This Cuban-inspired cocktail is made with fresh lime wedges, fresh mint, simple syrup, and white rum. Start by dropping 4 lime wedges and a handful of mint into a glass. Add simple syrup.
That's a lot of simple syrup.
Mm-mm.
Then muddle. Or if you have a mascot, have him do it.
You don't want to bruise the mint. You just want to release the oils.
You actually do want to bruise the mint to release the oils.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And you, no, Steve.
Then add rum. In this case, we're using Conch Republic light rum.
This is crafted in the spirit of the Conch Republic. It's not made in the Conch Republic, but it has the spirit of it.
It has the heart.
Then fill the glass with ice and shake.
You flip it. Top it.
He's getting good at that.
Top it off
soda.
With soda.
The drink is made, so throw in a few straws and sip away.
Wait, Zane, I have a question. Why would you put a straw in his drink?
We all hope for a better future. We give Steve the benefit of the doubt because I hope that Steve will at some point enjoy a cocktail rather than chugging it.
Not happening. That's what we do with the straws. Okay.
Is that right, Pat? I'm going to do that?
All right, fine. No straws.
Cheers. I don't know what we're talking about.
Salud.
Cheers.
Salud.
So we sip, or at least I do. Coming up on Drinking Made Easy, yo-ho-ho in a bucket of rum.
Welcome back to Drinking Made Easy. Did you know that Key West is one of the only places in the country where you can walk around with an open container? One of only about six places. It's not necessarily legal, but it's not really illegal.
I didn't know that until like 2 minutes ago.
You can learn stuff like that at the website and for recipes that you learned in today's show.
And for the ones that we forgot to mention.
Right. Go to drinkingmadeeasy.com.
Let me clarify. Under the Key West Ordinance 18-87, it's illegal to carry an open container of alcoholic beverage on the sidewalks and streets of Key West. So it's technically not legal, but as long as you have a plastic cup, no one seems to mind. In fact, with the bars on the sidewalk, they kind of cater to it. We're drinking our way through Key West, and our next stop is at another one of Pat Croce's places, the Green Parrot. John, the manager, wouldn't let us start the scene until we had one of their root beer barrels, which is a shot of root beer schnapps dropped into a beer.
To the parrot.
To the parrot.
To the parrot.
To the parrot.
Salute.
Then, John gives me the history on why the Green Parrot is a Key West icon.
The beginning of World War II, submarine base opened up down on the Navy base down the street. 1941.
Okay.
And this was specifically the submariner's bar. That's all along out here with submarine sailors.
Okay.
Marine Corps went down the street, regular Navy went somewhere else, all submarine sailors. 1971, the Navy pulled out. It became kind of a hangout, bohemian hangout, hippies and whatnot, and then became a shrimper's bar.
So it changed from the submariners to shrimpers?
Submariners to hippies to shrimpers.
Got it.
And then it went through several incarnations until we've come to now, and it's still a bohemian hangout, writers, artists, whatnot.
And hippies like Steve.
Hippies like Steve.
This is one of the Key West institutions. If you come to Key West, this is one of the places people have to come.
Absolutely.
Why is that?
It's not created for anything but what has kind of evolved here.
Right.
It's organic. Over the years, we've generated this incredible stream of bands that come through here for the same reason. It's a real bar. The customers are very sophisticated when it comes to what they want to hear.
Got it.
On Friday night, they're three deep out in the street listening to a Latin funk hip-hop band or a blues band or a reggae band.
They're also known for their Bloody Marys, a local hangover remedy. It starts with key limes.
Squeeze the key lime in there because we're in the Keys.
This is a key lime.
That's, yep.
What's the difference between a key lime and a lime lime?
It's a little bit more sour, I believe.
Really?
Yeah.
The Green Parrot Bloody Mary is made with Tabasco sauce, Worcestershire sauce, key limes, salt and pepper, pickled bean juice, vodka, top off with tomato juice, and shake. Then garnish with some Caribe pickled green beans.
That's a couple of pairs of legs there.
Oh,
I hope
nice.
These are spicy.
When Lamprey sees a straw, that means there's a challenge.
You gotta keep it down and drink out of the straw. Here we go.
One, two, three, go!
Lamprey pulls it down. Then he eats the green beans.
Eat the beans. Gotta eat the beans.
And Lamprey is the winner.
Have you ever thought about having a Drinking Made Easy throwback hour here?
Steve, you know what my question is? Does drinking really need to be made easier?
Not for me, but we do it for the people at home.
Our final stop was Pat Croce's Rum Barrel, which claims to have the best selection of rum anywhere.
We challenge anyone to have a better selection of rum anywhere in the universe.
Pretty much.
Anyone.
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 Not pretty much. Anyone.
They're approaching 200 different rums from all over the world.
I'm gonna talk about the places you have rum from. I'm gonna do it really quickly.
Oh boy, here we go.
Barbados, Bermuda, Brazil, Colombia, Costa Rica, Dominican Republic, Fiji, Guyana, Guatemala, Haiti, Jamaica, Martinique, Mexico, Netherlands, Nicaragua, Panama, Peru, Puerto Rico, Spain, St. Kitts, Trinidad and Tobago, United States, Venezuela, Virgin Islands. First of all, why rum?
The Caribbean Islands. This is the only island in the continental United States that's in the Caribbean.
I start off with their $34 smooth landings flight.
Wow, this is called the smooth landings flight.
After having their $34 smooth landings flight, I get sold on their $100 millionaire's flight.
I don't know if you're doing the upsell or the downsell, whatever you just did, but I think you're trying to get me to buy the millionaire's and I just bought it.
After having their millionaire's flight, I was ready for their signature cocktail, the Kill Devil, served in a 1 gallon bucket.
This might be something that Pat would like us to do.
You do whatever you want.
The Kill Devil originally was Blackbeard's drink.
Okay.
You get rum and sprinkle on top of it gunpowder. Light it up and challenge his mates to guzzle it.
got any gunpowder?
We don't, so we use something different.
Instead of gunpowder, the Kill Devil is made with mango rum, coconut rum, southern comfort, amaretto, sloe gin, grenadine, orange juice, and pineapple juice. Drop in a cup of fruit soaked in 151 proof rum, then, for good measure, float more 151 proof rum on top.
Oh yeah, that's good, that's good.
Good. This is for how many people?
Choose four.
How can we incentivize you?
Maybe a bottle of your finest rum to go.
So if you destroy that in under 2 minutes, you'll give him one of your finest bottles of rum.
Yes, but
I'm a negotiator.
Yeah, what if he loses?
That's exactly right. What if you lose? What if you have to stop?
Well, then I will give you one of my finest bottles.
Get the
rum.
Are you kidding?
You have nothing the man wants.
No.
I am not a negotiator.
No, well, how about this? How about this? If you can't drink it, you'll wear it.
No, I don't think you have to be so angry.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, McKenna has to power through this gallon in under 2 minutes. The ice has taken up half the room, so it's really only a half gallon of the booze. But the ice is also making it very cold, which constricts the throat and makes it difficult to swallow.
You are about quarter way through, and a quarter of your time has transpired. We're approaching a minute. I think you're gonna pick it up and drink it.
Steve looks like he's manning up and puts the bucket in his face. He looks like he might have it. Or maybe not.
Oh, it's burning.
We do call it the Kill Devil for a reason.
Yeah, it's called the Kill Devil. It's got two bad words in it.
But if you finish it, you'd be one of Blackbeard's crew.
Three, two, one.
Go ahead, help him out. There you go. There you go. Hey, you made it.
I knew I could do it.
Can I get another one? Oh, can I have...
It's so good.
Drinking.
His chance to get back.
Check us out on Facebook and at drinkingmadeeasy.com.